Yo, what up guys? Welcome back to Patched.
Welcome back, and today we got a big one for you today. So we're reviewing the Microsoft Surface Pro X. Now, this is a sort of like a combination between a tablet and a computer. I would say closer to a tablet. Now, Microsoft's, their Surface lineup is pretty tried and true. They're known for being super, super reliable. Right now, they've released the Pro 7 as a new one, and then the Surface Laptop 3 as sort of their new lineup. And then they introduced this Pro X, which sort of came out of nowhere. Seemed like it should have been the replacement to the Surface Go, which was their sort of smaller predecessor to this. But that one had a Pentium Gold, so we don't talk about it. So let's get it started off with the pricing. Now, this guy starts at a high price at $1,000.
Oh my God.
For this guy.
Yeah.
And comes just as a tablet, mind you. So no keyboard, no pen, nothing, just a tablet.
You want to talk about the attachments? Like, if you want to use it as an actual laptop, I guess like on-the-go laptop.
Yeah.
Then obviously you're going to want a keyboard, and I guess if you're drawing or something, you're going to want a pen as well, yeah. Right?
Now as far as the accessories goes, you can buy them individually. So the pen costs $145 for this little guy.
That's insane.
And this sticks into the keyboard, which on its own is $140.
So are they trying to be Apple? Or I don't understand, you know? That's insane, you know?
And then if you want to get them bundled, they actually sell a bundle with the keyboard and the pen combined. For $270.
But I guess so, you're saving 10 bucks.
By the time you pay that $1,000 price point, yes. You're not done yet. Yes. You're not done yet.
Yeah.
I mean, that being said, you could connect any Bluetooth keyboard to it. But, I mean, they also have an option. So, starts at $1,000. They have an option for a model with 256 gigs because the base will come with 128.
Wow.
256 gigs of storage will cost you, I mean, on Best Buy's website and B&H, it's on sale for $1,250. So, you know, $1,250, that's on sale for $300.
It was $1,569.
Yeah, so that bundle will come with the keyboard and the pen already in it, and 2x the storage. So, doesn't hurt to have. I'm assuming you guys are going to be wondering about the specs in this bad boy. Storage, you can get up to 512 gigabytes of storage. Now, the interesting thing about this guy is you can actually put a SIM card in there and get a 4G connection if you want to. So, that's a cool option. Being that this is mainly going to be catered towards business sort of work, operating, and then viewing experience, of course. So having connection anywhere, I would imagine, would be important. Now, as far as the processor goes in there, I know we're expecting like i5, i7, something like that. Now, it's the Microsoft SQ1 processor. So this is an ARM chip. It's a 64-bit operating system, but the limitations of this ARM-based chip means you can only install 32-bit applications. And that's a phrasing I'm sure you haven't heard in a while, 32-bit.
32-bit, guys.
Wow. Now, you can use some 64-bit applications that have been ported to be used with the ARM chip, but not all. And Microsoft does specify that on their website in the fine text.
Yeah, and I think because of that, that might be a deal breaker for some people. Because like, if you're obviously trying to replace your laptop with this, that's going to be a pretty big limitation.
Yeah, and then the apps, I mean, I was trying to stick to the Microsoft Store for apps, but even ones from there just weren't running as well as you'd expect.
Yeah.
Chrome runs well, Edge runs really well as far as browsers go, and of course Microsoft Office runs really, really well. But I think that's about the main usage for this system.
Yeah.
And then viewing experience. The display is 2880 by 1920. So it's a beautiful, beautiful display, actually.
Yes. What are they calling it? It's similar to, I guess, what Apple calls their Retina display.
Yeah, they have their... So it is running the Microsoft sort of Pixel Sense display, which is just... I mean, it looks good. It's the same as sort of Apple using their own phrasing. It's Retina display, which makes you think it's better.
And you can't really see the pixels to the naked eye.
Yeah, no screen door effect. At all. So it is really, really good for a viewing experience. As far as battery life goes, you can get up to 13 hours of battery life on this guy, which is crazy. And that's because of that ARM-based processor. It doesn't use a whole lot of power. Doesn't suck a whole lot of power. And then the screen size is exactly 13 inches. I mean, that's going to be across.
That's a big... I mean, for a laptop, that's small. But then for like a tablet, that's huge.
Yeah.
You know, so.
The form factor is nice because in between, so the iPad Pro is 12.9 inches. Your typical 13-inch laptop is about 13.3.
Yes. And the bezels, I guess you would say, are pretty thin.
Slim. As slim as they can be, because you still have Windows Hello in here. You still need to add speakers. And then, of course, you can actually remove the SSD that's in there. But they also add in that it's not exactly for expandability. It's not user removable. You have to have it removed by an expert.
No.
So a Microsoft expert. So yeah, Very strange.
As far as the speakers go, though, the speakers are actually really nice. Yeah. It gets so loud. I was very surprised at how loud it was.
Yeah, and it's really good because, again, the viewing experience is sort of one of those things that I was really focusing on with this guy because I don't really use a lot of Microsoft Office or anything like that. Yeah. So the viewing experience was nice. Speakers were loud. Usually, the speakers are an afterthought on, like, a tablet.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's nice to have.
Yeah,
sure.
And it's also stereo, so you have speakers on both the left and right side, mm-hmm. which is nice compared to like the iPad that I have. It's just speakers on the bottom, which kind of sucks. So.
And then this guy is 7.5 millimeters thin on this, and so it's super, super thin. I mean, so just taking it off here, you can just see it's ridiculously portable. I mean, you've got an adjustable stand in the back, which goes to our next category being the build quality.
Usually, if there's a hinge, there's only a few types of angles that you can actually put the device at. But with this hinge, you can put it at basically any angle you want. It stops
essentially all the way back.
Exactly.
Right, nearly.
And it's a very sturdy hinge. It really doesn't move easily. So you have to kind of like put some pressure on it to actually move it, which I think is very nice.
Yeah, it makes it feel a little bit more sturdy when you're moving it. You don't feel like it's going to just like slap against the desk at any point.
And also, I think it's really good if you're like on the train or on the go in the airport, you can just put it on your lap, you know, and have the hinge like really at a steep angle. And you can just have it on your lap and have it at a comfortable viewing angle, you know, because like for my iPad, the actual case that I have with it, there's only two angles on that, you know, and then there's really no way for me to just put it on my lap and view it comfortably. So I really like the hinge on this.
Yeah, and then as far as the port selection goes on this, you've got two USB Type-C ports that can be adapted into just about anything. So they pull an Apple here, switch to only Type-C, although it is too thin to fit a full-size USB.
Yes.
So you're going to be using dongles until everything else finally switches over to USB-C. As far as the charger goes, they are using their magnetic charger, which Microsoft is pretty known for. They do that same thing Apple used to do, but it charges fast. I haven't had any issues with the charger. It's really nice, really sleek looking, but they are expensive if you have to replace them. So this charger will run you $90 to replace should you lose the charger. They're very expensive and they are proprietary, so you do run into issues if you have to replace it.
So as far as the actual tablet goes, for me personally, well, I'm an Apple guy. I'm sucked into the Apple ecosystem. And I have an iPad, iPhone, iMac, and all that, which is really nice, you know? But I was using this, and specifically for media consumption, because personally, I didn't really use it for like office work, like Microsoft Office. So for, you know, viewing videos, it has a really nice screen. It's a big screen, and it's super thin, very portable, and I also really like the hinge. It wasn't very buttery smooth for me, you know? Like, there would be some hiccups, you know? It would have trouble loading sometimes, and, you know, for me, like on my iPad, I like never have that issue, you know? And you're paying like base price for $1,000 for this. And I mean, if you're okay with that, then, you know, it's a great buy, I would say.
Yeah, I would say for what it's catered towards, for the users that it's catered towards, it does a good job.
Mm-hmm.
But anything past that, if you're trying to step into, I mean, gaming and selling your own application, anything like that, any Photoshop, professional work like that, I would look elsewhere. Even so, for $1,000, tough to recommend.
It is,
because this is going to be catered towards your user who is using, I mean, with 128 gigs of storage, let's say you get Office 365, you got your Word, PowerPoint, Excel, all that. You use your cloud storage mainly, which is fine. And again, super portable for that user, long-lasting battery life, which is great. But if you were going to be doing any more than that, I mean, you can get a Pro 7, Surface Pro 7, running, you know, full Windows, and then run any applications you want. It's going to be, you know, a little bit heavier, a little bit thicker, but you're going to be able to run whatever you want on it, and for a very, very similar price.
So I would say for this, you know, actual product, it's for a specific niche, you know, very small amount of people.
They really cater towards such a small audience here. I feel like we really missed the bar with this one.
Yeah.
Now, if the price point was lower, maybe the $600-$700 range, that's possible. Even still, you can get a laptop for that much, like a decent laptop for that much.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's a cool concept, but I don't think it's fleshed out enough yet.
Yeah.
Now, once you've got all the keyboard, which is really nice, once you've got the pen, it adds a little bit more to it, but also for a lot more money.
Yeah.
You're spending another $270 around there.
So like we said, we wouldn't recommend it for most people. If you really want a portable device that's capable of, you know, just your basic needs, media consumption, Microsoft Office and stuff like that, and you're willing to spend a lot of money, then this is a great product for you.
That is the thing, because you can get like a Chromebook that can do this for $200, or even a crappy little laptop for $400 that would do it with Windows. But the thing about the Surface family is you do always get a premium product, so it's going to last a lot longer than all of those devices.
Yeah.
And of course look a lot better. So you do pay for a premium product.
So if you guys do want to get it, we'll leave a link in the description box. But that's the review. Hope you guys enjoyed, and we'll see you guys next one.
See you in the next one.